2020.
Yeah, it's been quite the journey.
Yes, it has. Yeah. So why don't we go just a little bit farther back, just to give people context. Mm. When were we married?
June 28, 2014, Africa Meeting House.
All right. Okay. Good memory. Mm-hmm. Well, that was a wonderful day. Our pastors definitely did a wonderful wedding ceremony, so we really enjoyed it. What happened in 2016?
We had Amara, our beautiful daughter, who's now 4.
Yes.
And she's a bundle of joy. And we're just really excited about her. And it was also the year that I went away and started working overseas.
Oh, September 28th. Mm-hmm. 2016. Amara was 7 months old and he flew to Haiti and started working for USAID. And we thought it was just going to be a separation of a year, and it turned into 4 years. Mm-hmm. So we used all forms of communication.
We used WhatsApp and mm-hmm. we used FaceTime and we used
Skype,
and
email,
Zoom.
And we tried to maintain consistent communication by talking twice a day. Sometimes we read books to Amara, but we always prayed. That was mm-hmm. one thing that was very consistent. So what was the hardest thing about being away from your wife and daughter?
Just making sure that you guys were really protected and making sure that you guys were safe. It was definitely a struggle. You know, we're blessed with family and friends and our church community. Yeah. What do you think the most difficult part was?
Well, I mean, my love languages are physical touch and quality time. So mm-hmm. You can't really do that over Zoom. And 2019, we were able to buy another 2 families. So that was really good. And so we knew that the end was coming. So we were just in constant prayer about him getting a job here. And when it came through, that was really, really exciting. Mm-hmm. And so you came home. You came home this year. Yeah. So Amara, how did you feel when Daddy came home?
Happy.
So you were home for 2 weeks or something? Mm-hmm. And then my parents got sick with COVID. Oh, God's timing. Ugh. I had to leave. I had to go to my parents' house for 2 weeks.
That was, if nothing else, it was certainly God giving me a window into what Keeana must have dealt with over the last few years.
You don't really know how much you need your friends and your loved ones and your church family until something goes down. You guys stepped in. And so, I love you, Mark.
Love you.
So we would like to wish everyone at Bethel a very happy new year. We know that 2021 is right around the corner, and we hope that 2021 is not going to be as newsworthy as 2020 is.
Yeah, we're praying for everyone, praying for continued resilience in the face of these difficult times. Stay in the faith, stay connected to God, connected to each other, and we're wishing you guys all the best. God bless you all.
God bless.